Let's look at the basic joints in Unity. In this example, we have fixed joints and spring joints. This example forms a basic wrecking ball that does this. Firstly, the fixed joint. Fixed joints work in a similar way to parenting objects in the hierarchy. The joint simply locks a game object to the point in the world or to a connected rigid body. In this example, we simply have placed the first capsule in the chain up near the ceiling and attached a fixed joint. This locks it in place. The other parameters of this fixed joint are break force and break torque. This is the minimum amount of force required to break the joint. When the joint is broken, the game object can once again move freely. The other capsules in the chain have spring joints. Spring joints work on the principle that the game object is trying to reach a target position. The target position that it's trying to reach is the position that it's set to in the scene view, and any rigid bodies that are attached to it will pull it away from this position on an invisible spring attached to the anchor point. If the spring joint has a connected rigid body, then the target point that the spring is trying to reach is relative to that game object rather than to world space. So for example, the second capsule here is trying to reach capsule 1, and capsule 3 is trying to reach capsule 2. As these move, they'll no longer be heading towards the original positions, rather they'll be heading towards the anchor point of wherever those capsules happen to be. The anchor is the pivot point of the joint. You should consider it as where the spring is attached to the game object. This is shown in the scene view by an orange dot or box. The spring parameter is a measure of how strong the spring is. The higher the value, the tighter or stronger the spring becomes. The damper parameter is how much the joint will slow down under motion. The higher the number, the less the spring will overshoot. The min and max distances are for setting up a sort of dead zone for where the spring isn't active. They effectively restrict the length of the spring. Similar to the fixed joint, the spring also has a break force and a break torque, which you can set to a certain amount in order to define the minimum force required to break that joint. Finally, hinge joints. Hinge joints are ideal for things like doors and share some properties with spring joints. The axis of the hinge is the one that it rotates around. In this example, our physics door has the hinge joint attached. The anchor is set to 1 in the x-axis, which moves it over to its edge. Again, the joint is represented in orange in Unity, and you can see a small line showing you where the hinge is currently located. The axis then allows us to specify around which axis the hinge will pivot. We've set this to the y-axis so that it'll react like a real hinge. With a simple script, we're applying a force to the door when we click on it, which pushes it backwards in its z-axis, using the shortcut -transform.forward. In the add force lesson, you may have seen that this fires the door straight out of the frame. But now that we have a hinge, when we apply the force to the door, it simply pivots around that point. And no matter how many times we add force to it, it doesn't break. In a similar manner to our spring joint, we can apply spring-like characteristics by using the Use Spring checkbox and using the values underneath the spring settings. The other differences between hinge joints and spring joints are motors and limits. Motors are for introducing a velocity to your joint, for example, a revolving door. The target velocity is the velocity the joint is trying to rotate at, and the force is used to try and attain that velocity. If free spin is checked, then the force will only be used to try and accelerate the joint and not to decelerate it. Limits can be used if you wish to constrain the motion of your joint, like with a normal door. The minimum and maximum are the angles between which the joint can move. Min and max bounce are the amount by which the joint will bounce when it reaches one of its limits. And similar to our spring joint, yet again we have break forces and torques. For example, if we add in a reasonably low number into break force, we can break the door off the hinge when adding a force. You should note that when doing this, the door doesn't fly directly backwards, but instead is pulled away from its hinge,